Alamin ang mga istoryang umabot sa newsfeed mo. Mga istoryang kasalukuyang nangyayari. Mga istoryang gagawa ng ingay.
Dahil sa hirap ng buhay, kung kaya't marami, mostly na mga kababaihan ang gumagawa ng part-time job para makatulong sa gastusin sa bahay. Isa na sa pinaka-popular na part-time ay ang online seller. Ngunit hindi lahat ay nagiging successful dito. Ngayong araw ay hihingi tayo ng tips sa founder, CEO, bigatin itong gagawin natin, BDI Inc., ang Franella Mall, and also isang certified seller trainer and ambassador, accredited Lazada service provider. Naging awardee din siya ng bilang Outstanding Young Lady Entrepreneur sa 37 People's Choice Award. Please welcome Miss Mj Gaan.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, Mj, pag-usapan muna natin kung ano yung trabaho mo, no?
Of course.
Paano ka na-connect doon sa Lazada? Kasi yun ang medyo kilala nila.
Yes, go ahead. It started about less than 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. So, we have this company first, BDI Incorporated. Mm. That's the very first company I started.
That's your company.
That's my company. And we are a service provider company. I mean, we are more of business development, business strategic planning, training, IT services, all of diversified siya and consulting firm.
Uh-oh.
Eventually,
sino ang mga clients natin doon sa BDI?
Usually mga B2B clients, okay. Mga companies, small, medium and large companies. Mm. What we do with them is we give a strategic business plan for their business. Kung okay. meron kaming mga ready-made businesses, all they need to do is just invest into that and then we will implement it. May ganon. So it's like...
So parang one-stop shop na kayo.
Yeah,
ano?
Oh. Yeah. So, ganon siya. So, may trainings din kami, may manpower din kami, meron din kaming... A lot of different business solutions, in short.
Okay. So, for example, meron akong itatayong negosyo. Ito para mas sa kanila, no? Pag magtatayo ako ng, sabihin natin, isang negosyo at gusto kong makakuha ng mga online engagement, online views, online communication... community,
yes.
Tapos na may communication, I go to BDI.
Yes, definitely. Because we our tagline is your strategic partner.
Okay. So, para kayong consultant firm, nitong mga negosyante na ito, kahit na existing na sila, matagal na sila, at yung mga mag-start pa lang.
Correct. You've got it right.
Ah, okay. Yes. So, yun ang service ng BDI.
Yes, that's how we started.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, kanina off the air, the way I understand, Lazada ay isa sa mga supposed to be na clients ninyo na naging partner ninyo. Paano ba?
Well, hindi talaga ganon. Just so happened, kami ngayon, in BDI, since we are doing, we have creative services, so
okay.
Partner rin siya ng services namin. So, we are now also providing creative services to Lazada Philippines. So, because we have group of people on the creative team like multimedia artists,
yes.
Content writers,
since you're
digital
doing
marketing,
it na nga.
Since we're doing it na rin. So, but before we became a service provider of Lazada, we became a merchant muna.
Uh-huh.
So doon nagsimula yung Franetta Mall naman.
Okay, merchant is parang seller.
Seller in short. Yes. Mm. So naging seller muna kami ni Lazada through Franetta Mall.
Okay.
So
Franetta Mall parang ito ay isang ito para mas maintindihan ninyo mga kababayan. Ito ay isang mall na lahat ng kailangan nyo sa mall ay nandito.
Yes.
Pero virtual. Kumbaga online.
Online. Correct.
Okay.
Yes.
So, yun muna, yung Franetta Mall muna. Pag pinasok ko yung Franetta Mall, sabihin natin, kinanap ko yan sa website, ay sa internet, nakita ko yung website, ano makikita ko sa Franetta Mall?
We are categorized into 5.
Okay.
So, we have home and beauty, wellness and beauty.
Okay.
Meron din kaming fashion category, electronics, digital goods and services, and... So there are five categories na pinabenta namin sa Franetta Mall. And all of this, pinasok din namin siya sa Lazada.
Okay, pero yung mga produkto ninyo sa Franetta Mall, nag-a-apply yung expertise ninyo.
Yes.
So maganda talaga siyang puntahan.
Yes, correct.
Doon kayo napansin ng Lazada.
Well, napansin kami kasi we were one of those top, included on the top merchants of
Because
Lazada.
You know what you're doing.
Yes, definitely. We know how to sell it sa Lazada. We know how to position a product, how to brand a product,
yes.
How to make really attractive content and design and layout. So yun.
Wow. parang ang laki nung ano. Mm-hmm. Tapos nung napunta na kayo ng when Lazada started talking to you, ano na nangyari?
So doon na. So we continuously became one of the top merchants of Lazada Philippines through Franeta Mall. Eventually, Lazada approach us to become a service provider na rin nila. So, okay. MJ, how did you guys do with your layouts, your product contents, your branding in Franeta Mall for Lazada? Now, maybe you could also share that expertise to other Lazada merchants,
bakit?
Other Lazada
kasi
sellers.
Kasi lahat ng mga nagpupunta ng Lazada, napupunta na sa inyo?
Hindi. Kasi they know na kung gagawin din nila yung kung ano ginagawin naming strategy, most likely it will also happen to them as a seller.
Oh, pero nakukuha na nila yung, nakukuha nyo na yung pansin, nung pansin ng mga market nila.
Correct. And because of that, it's a help for Lazada community.
Tama.
So we provide our services to them. In return, they get our service. We help them out then. Mm. So yun.
If you can't beat them, join them.
Correct. Tama.
Bakit hindi? Sila lang ba?
Yes. So.
Okay. Iwan muna natin yung Lazada.
Yes, of course.
Pero, sige, balikan natin ng konti. You being an ambassador.
Oh, yes.
Anong job mo doon?
An ambassador? Well, so, ito na. Nagsimula na kaming...
Kasama yan sa BDI services?
Hindi.
Expertise nyo rin
yan. Expertise ka namin yun, definitely. Oh. So,
pero you're now giving your service to Lazada lang?
Yeah, we are also giving to Lazada. But we're giving this services not only with Lazada, with other, definitely with other industries.
Yes.
Kasi yun yung core namin eh. So now, ito na, nangyayari na, we are already a service provider of Lazada, one of the top merchants of Lazada. Personally, they picked me to become also, MJ, why not become a certified Lazada seller trainer and ambassador?
Okay.
So, with that, you will represent your store.
Parang saya-saya nun, eh?
Oo.
Parang lumawak yung
correct,
ano mo, di ba?
Correct. So, I have that
privilege. And you were very happy.
Of course. Nung
kinuha ka.
Of course, opo. It's my passion to really share my knowledge and learnings to others. And if I've been successful in this field, I would let them also experience the same. So, ganun ginawa ko. So, I train in Lazada University. So, I do trainings, physical and webinars. And eventually, hindi lang nga nagtapos doon dahil so I do this kind of services to Lazada na. There's another opportunity. They appointed me again to become mag-leverage yung appointment sa akin.
Ah, okay.
Yes. So another training was given to me. This is more of trainer's training na, but this time it's a global na. So hindi lang for Lazada but other companies like Alibaba has already been part of my expertise na. So kumbaga they appointed me to become I've gone through Lazada, Taobao, Alibaba training. Last week lang, it's a 5 days intensive training. I've gone through all the tests and presentation. So sa awa ng Diyos, nakapasa ako and I've been certified with Lazada and Alibaba. So yun.
So sino employer mo? Lazada o BDI?
Actually, there's really no employment eh.
Oh,
wala siyang employment relationship. More of partnership siya.
Partnership.
Yeah, more of partnership
siya. With the BDI thing?
Yes.
Sila ba yung mother company mo?
Yes.
Ay, hindi, BDI kasi
BDI
it's your company.
Correct.
Oo nga pala. Okay, iwan muna natin yung Lazada. Okay, pag-usapan naman natin, bago tayo mawala ng oras, yung mga mag-i-start pa lang, please give them advice, MJ, please. Doon sa mga nagiging seller at reseller sa Lazada, ano ang mga dapat nilang tandaan? And I wanna listen.
Okay. Well, number one, if you want to start a business and you want to start with Lazada, number one kung sinasabi...
Pwede bang wag muna sa wag Lazada?
Okay,
kung
sige.
Mag-i-start pa lang.
Mag-start ng any start business. Any business.
Ito pa magalit sa akin Lazada. Baka hindi na ako maka-order. Okay.
Well, number one, is there any existing products or services ka na ba ngayon?
Okay.
If there is, now next step is, of course, your goal is to sell that products or services.
Yes.
Now, either you do two things. You go offline or you go online.
Okay.
But since we're talking about online, so best things first is whatever products that you have right now, continue on selling that on whatever platform ginagamit mo. We will just gonna ship it into a more diverse scale, which is We sell it through online. So, okay. Yun.
For example, merong isang nanay sa isang malayong probinsya na nanggaling ng Tesda at at gumagawa siya ng sabong panlaba.
Wow.
Powder. Okay, yes. How do you sell that?
Number one, my question is, what kind of sabon ito?
Okay.
Is this sabon for men or women? Because mayroon akong tatlong category na laging tinatanong
sabon
or kinoconsider.
Sabon na panlaba na for men and or women?
Ay, panlaba, sorry.
Panlaba.
Isip ko pala,
pabango.
Sabon na pang ano. Okay, panlaba. Correct. Now, the question is, how much is the price? May tatlo akong laging kinoconsider when it comes to...
How much is the price?
Yes, how much is the price? Is it market? Ang market mo ba dito, A, B, or C?
Pang
medyo mahal ba to?
Uh-huh. Pang labandera ba yan? Pang washing machine ba yan? Ganon.
So, yan. Okay. So we call it magic price. So, kung may magic price ka at pangmasa siya, that's good. Because what we are looking after is yung repeat purchases.
Okay.
So,
loyalty.
Correct. Royalty, repeat purchases. So, okay. So, you have your product na, you have the pricing na. Next thing for you is, you have to see kung ano yung mga available free resources online na pwede mong simulan. Okay, like for example, you have Facebook account. Pero Facebook itself is not really a selling platform. It's a marketing platform.
It's a marketing platform.
Yes. Okay. The good thing lang, Facebook has this marketplace.
Okay.
If you're familiar, may marketplace na. Doon, pwede ka na magbenta.
Sa marketplace
of Facebook.
Saan namin makikita ito?
Sa mismong Facebook account mo, meron doon sa personal page
may
mo. May nakalagay doon marketplace. On the left side, meron na doon. So, may opportunity sa mga users ng Facebook na you could already sell products online through wala nang ibang kailangan. Using your own Facebook account, makapag-sell ka na. Para siyang sulit. Para siyang OLX. You can sell it, buy and sell na doon. So, there. So,
button lang ito, no?
Yes, button lang siya.
Okay,
on the left side, marketplace, you can sell there. Now, next thing is, okay, you have to start with one product muna.
Okay.
Yan lagi ko sinasabi. It's okay na marami kang produkto, pero focus is important.
Okay.
So, you do all the marketing, advertising.
Why not two? Why not three? Why one?
Well, you could start eventually three to five.
Okay.
Pero if you already have your own products, okay. Pero sa mga hindi pa, wala pang produkto talaga, you want to start, kailangan mo rin kasing investment. So, magsisimula ka, anong produkto mo unang sisimulan? Gusto mo ba magsimula sa something na for personal care, home care? So, you have to think about it. Pero ang lagi ko sinasabi, go for products kapag starting ka pa lang na consumable. Ibig sabihin, pwedeng may repeat purchase.
Okay.
Say, for example, lipstick. Alam mo, pag naubos, bibili ulit ng tao. Unlike, for example, relo. Pag ang relo ba nasira, bibili ka or papaayos mo.
Okay.
So, there is a tendency na pwede mo munang paayos bago ka bumili.
Okay, can I give you a weird product?
Okay.
Kasi, ako, I do voiceovers for commercials, TV, radio, online. Okay. And I do scripts then. How do I sell myself?
Yourself. Online. We're
online.
Talking about online. This is a very good question because right now you have an opportunity already to sell be it services or products online. On your part, I would tell you could sell it through vouchers or gift certificates.
Okay.
So me to say for example, on Facebook or any platform, you have your own website.
Yes.
Okay. We create our own. That's how we also teach other people. If they want to have your own branding, for example, ABC Voice, how do you call that?
Services.
Sir, ABC Voice Services. abcvoiceservices.com. So you market you market that website, okay? You put all the advertisement, marketing, you sell it through gift certificate or voucher. So people will buy it through your website. Through vouchers lang. So, pwede rin actually cash on delivery. Pero, I suggest kung wala ka pang third-party logistics, you go for card payment na kapag ka mga gift certificates. Pero, ang good news lang, mabibenta mo na siya kahit hindi siya physical products. Uso na po yun ngayon kasi on our end sa Franeta Mall. If you would try to check, pati mga gift certificates we sell it na like mga IV glutathione, even lately, we just had a new account, resort. Mm-hmm. We sell resort houses through gift certificates.
Ah, really?
Through vouchers, yes. So, for example, if you want to book, malapit na ang Valentine's, sa mga couples po natin dyan, or family, if you want to book a two days resort at a certain area, you book it through our website, or through book it to other e-commerce platform, online platform. Ngayon, makukuha mo na siya through booking. May papadala lang sa yung order ID number through your email. Mm. So, yun lang ang labanan eh. Email address lang, payment through card, then you're good. Kung wala ka namang card, you can have like yung mga PayMaya, GCash, load it, pay it through, basta meron lang MasterCard and Visa. Mm. So, ikaw, pwede mo nang magawa yun as a service provider, as you are, this is your product. Mm. So, yun.
Pero, can I still use Twitter, Facebook,
yes,
YouTube din?
Yes, of course. Ito yung mga platforms na gagamitin mo for your marketing naman.
Marketing lang. Okay.
I mean, you could sell, it's not necessarily good as a selling platform, but marketing platform mo. Ang kailangan, pag may mga marketing platform ka na ganito, like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, ito yung mga usual marketing platforms are very effective because this is what we call platform with community na.
Uh-oh.
So people has their own access na as part of the community. The goal is, you have a call to action. For example, you post there, ABC voice services. We now have 30% off for the February purchasers or first 100 buyers. Go to our website, ABC. Doon sila magbubook. Ganun siya.
Okay.
Don't sell it on the marketing platform. Advertise there, promote there. Give a call to action link. Direct sila sa website nyo.
Okay. Why do I need or why do we have to need a website?
That's really your selling platform.
Okay.
That's really
because Facebook is not ours.
Well, yeah, you have your own account there.
Uh-oh.
Facebook should be used as a marketing platform because it has community. May traffic na doon. May tao na.
Uh-oh.
So, syempre, if you would like to market, there meron na dapat traffic doon.
Okay.
Doon sa platform na alam mong may makikinig sa'yo. May pero ang kailangan mo lang,
makikita ka.
So, call to action lang ang kailangan mo doon. So, put a link. Kaya dapat yung spiel mo, yung content mo, it's very important na something very catchy and attractive na hindi siya yung usual na nagbebenta ka. Para pag-click nila yon, pwedeng yung poster na nilagay mo doon or video na nilagay mo doon, directed na doon sa website link mo.
Mm, so, lalo na pagka humihingi sila ng mga samples.
Correct, yes. You could also give like a code, like a 30% off if you will book at this at our site, diretso sila doon.
Okay.
You could give a free 10% off if you will book on this, ganon. That's how I also does it on my own, on my personal feed sa Facebook and Instagram.
Mm.
So, yung mga upcoming trainings ko, for example, like I do e-commerce training, hindi ko siya binibenta sa sarili kong feed or Facebook feed. I just put a call to action direct doon sa website namin or direct doon sa selling platforms namin.
Oo. Kasi yung sabi mo nga, it's not a selling platform, it's a marketing platform.
Mm-hmm.
Yung Facebook, YouTube, sabi mo Twitter.
Correct.
Parang ang sinasabi mo, MJ, kailangan, pero importante din kung ano yung ipopost mo doon.
Of course.
Ipopost mo doon.
Importante yung content, importante yung layout mo. It should be really unique, creative. So, kaya, very important yan, the reason why we became also a creative service provider of Lazada Philippines because we provide really a unique kind of creative materials. Our posters, our layouts, our videos, our contents. Hindi siya paulit-ulit. You have to be very creative and be very innovative because what you're selling on your marketing platform are not products. What you're selling there are your words. It should be something na persuasive siya.
Hindi pwedeng reshare?
You could reshare.
1 month ago?
Pwede, of course. Pwede, actually, very effective yung resharing.
Uh-oh.
Pero people will only share if they see that your spiel or your content is something na shareable din, di ba?
Okay. So in short, ang sinasabi mo, dito sa mga social media platform, mag-i-invite ka lang dito and you sell yourself. Tapos, pag if you're dealing with a client na, they must go to the website.
Yes. That's where doon napapasok yung how do they pay. Kasi if they will go to your feed, babayad sila doon, magtatanong sila, you will entertain them manually. Eh. So they will chat you probably, how do I pay? You give your bank account.
Pag sa website,
automatic na yon. They will see there, they will just gonna read the details, book, reserve, buy, add to cart, diretso na yon. Andun na yung payment details, procedure, and then you will automatically receive it. That's how we do with our trainings. Right now, all our trainings are all being served and booked and reserved on our website. So, wala na kaming anything, hindi na kami nagbibigay ng mga details namin. Okay, ito yung gagawin mo. And doon, nandun na lahat. So imagine mo, it's very hassle-free for us. Automatic, we just get the payments directly from our bank accounts na.
Okay. So, mas maganda pa rin yung selling deal, yung deal mismo, mangyayari doon sa website.
Yes.
Parang
yes.
Pang-come-on mo lang
yung... Pang-come-on mo lang yung ano.
Okay. Itong masarap sa pagiging host, libre.
Oo.
Libre.
Correct.
Okay. Balikan natin si Manang. Ano, na ano ang susunod niyang pwedeng gawin? Kumbaga, nakakuha na siya, gumawa na siya ng account.
Yes.
Meron na siyang, parang ito na yung marketing. Paano niya na ibibenta yung kanyang produkto?
So, dito na magsisimula yung, so may product na siya.
Yes.
Anong product yung simulan niya? Say, yes. Tatlo or limang product yun, or bagong product man to, or existing products na. Basic lang. So, you have your products, you have your selling platform, which is your website, or anywhere. Actually, kahit wala kang website, maraming ang e-commerce platforms right now, diba? So, and then after that, you now start to market it. Ganun na ang pinaka basic model ng e-commerce or ng online selling. You have your product or supply, what we call supply. You have your selling platform, and then you have your marketing platform. Ganun na yon. And then eventually, kapag ka meron dun kasi sa selling platform mo, it should have to be complete na.
Okay.
So pag
okay.
Nagmamarket ka na, so
okay,
market mo siya sa Facebook, sa Instagram, sa YouTube or anything, continue yung postings mo, yung updates mo. Kailangan yung selling platform mo kompleto na. It has to have fulfillment na. It has to have payment options na. It has to have everything na. So, hindi ka nag mag-iisip. Not unlike na wala kang selling platform. You sell it lang sa mismong may product ka nga. Mabenta yung product mo. Marami pa rin gumagawa niya ngayon. And in fairness, they're really earning good. No? Pero, very tedious to. I mean, how could you leverage your business more kung ikaw ng ikaw, third-party platform na libre naman. O kung merong mang cut to, that is for your own benefit. Kasi, ililessen mo yung trabaho mo eh. Instead of you na ikaw pa yung mag-pack, for example, if it's yung sabon nga, ikaw pa yung mag-deliver, ikaw pa yung magkukuha ng payments sa Palawan or what, etc. Doon na lang lahat sa selling platform. Ganun.
Okay, wala na tayong masyadong oras, pero
yes.
Ipasok ko lang to. If social media is a platform for marketing,
yes.
Do you advise to answer some bashing there, complaints? How do we go about this, MJ?
It's hindi kasi mawala yan eh. This is what we call inevitable things. And I guess it's important that you continue entertaining them. But to the point where you have to set limitations. If there are mga harsh words, set like you block all those harsh words and delete it and probably message them privately.
Okay.
And it's better na like that rather than makipagsagot kayo doon tapos sasagot ulit siya. It doesn't really help other community or other people na nandun sa community.
Kasi sa complaints, talaga walang right answer dyan, di ba?
Correct.
Hindi talaga masasatisfy yan.
Correct.
Kahit,
kami, what we do, as much as possible, we want it all our answers customized. Kasi, mahirap din ki-templated lahat. Minsan doon pumapasok yung bash din nila kasi they feel
robot.
Automated
yung,
and all. So, hindi mo iwasan yon pero you have to entertain. Everywhere, nandun naman yan eh. So, I guess one thing important is if it's something na very harsh talaga or beyond your limitation na beyond your rules na on your company or in your business, you could probably delete them but answer them back privately.
Okay.
Pwede yun. That's one. That's one. That's how we also sometimes do it. And then all the rest, you have to answer them customized sana. So there should be somebody na who could answer back na more than you. Pero kung automated naman, usually gano'n lang lagi. How. Ang gagawin mo, that's where yung selling platform mo papasok. Call to action, this is where you buy it. Go to this link for more details. Papasok na sila doon.
Okay. MJ, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you so much.
We learned a lot. I learned a lot. Maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat. An opportunity.
Gasin. Ano nga ba ang magaling?
Maraming nahuhugasan ito. Hindi papatalo ang smart ko.
Sa kalinisan ng hugasin, makikita ang galing. Ang smart, may over 80% more cleaning power kaysa leading liquid brand. May double tanggaling formula. Tanggal galing ang sebo, tanggal galing ang bakterya. Sa presyong abot kaya. Kaya lipat na sa number 1, Smart Dishwashing Base. Tanggaling galing. Also available, Smart Dishwashing Liquid. ACS.
Tingnan nyo oh, puti ito.
Mas puti ito.
Mas puti ito. Mas puti ito. Mas puti ito.
Sa Pride Bar, pwedeng hindi na mag-bleach, tina o anyel. Dahil ang Pride Bar ay may power whitener na nanunood sa bawat hibla. Kaya ang gamit ay kislap puti at panayat pa sa kamay.
Mas puti ito. Mas puti ito. Mas puti ito.
Pride Bar, hindi lang puti, kislap puti.
ACS.
Alamin ang mga istoryang umabot sa newsfeed mo, mga istoryang kasalukuyang nangyayari, mga istoryang gagawa ng ingay. Alamin, maging updated sa mga isyung gumagawa ng ingay on air and online live sa DZRH News Television at DZRH Radio at DZRH Digital, Facebook, YouTube at DZRH News Website. DZRH Network News. Kabalitaan si Reggie Espiritu araw-araw, alas 12:00 Lunes hanggang Biyernes. Kasama ang lahat ng naglilingkod sa pagbabalita, maging una sa kung ano ang bago sa DZRH Network News.
Nangunguna sa public service, nangunguna sa pagbabalita, ang kauna-unahang himpilan ng radyo sa bansa, DZRH, sa 80 taong paglilingkod sa bayan, higit na pinalawak ang makabagong bayanihan.